People moving out, people moving in. Why? Because of the color of the skin.
Run, 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 but you sure can't hide.
Well, nobody's interested in learning but the teacher. Segregation, determination, demonstration, integration, aggravation, diminution.
Good morning and welcome to Detroit Wants to Know. We're coming to you from the 2016 Wayne County Treasurer Show Cause hearings at 400 Monroe, the lovely International Marketplace. But before I get into that, I'm going to talk to you about something. I want to talk to you teachers. Teachers, you need to stop these sick outs. You need to stop it. Right now, you have public opinion on your side, but you're doing damage to the kids by doing the sick outs. You're doing it. We know that you have deplorable conditions to work in. We know that you have overcrowding in some classrooms. We know that your health care is jacked up. You've gotten everybody's attention. You've gotten national attention. You need to stop this. Parents are starting to lose their jobs because their kids have been out so often. There have been so many absences. Please, teachers, I'm asking you, stop these sick outs now. Let the bureaucrats do their thing. Let Brian Banks and the Detroit delegation from the state representatives fight for you. Let it happen. But stop these sick outs, because if you don't, you're going to sway public opinion the other way and you will become vilified. Now, on to why we're here. My friends, if you look out in back of me, you'll see the mass of people at the show cause hearing trying to save their houses. The treasurer does not want your property, but unfortunately there's so many people in Detroit that can't afford their taxes. They can't afford their taxes because our economy in Detroit has not come back. 2 weeks ago, I had Adolph Mongo on the show saying that if we don't do something about jobs in the neighborhood, we're sitting on a tender box. Well, you're seeing the tender. You're seeing the tender right here. We have got to bring jobs to our neighborhood. The treasurer is doing a yeoman's job of helping people save their homes. But program after program, year after year, it's not good. We've got to get these people here so they can afford to stay in their houses without a program. That has to be our goal. Mayor Duggan, Dan Gilbert, Mary Barra, I plead with you, get us some jobs in our neighborhood. Get us some jobs so we can stop all this. When we come back, I'm going to introduce you to the newly appointed treasurer, Richard Hathaway. We're going to learn who this guy is and how he got to where he was and how you can stay in your home. We'll be right back with Detroit Wants to Know.
This is Arthur Bricker of Bricker Tunis Furs in West Bloomfield. We're back with the biggest fur clearance sale in our history. Save 40 to 70% off on women's and men's furs and shearlings. Choose from mink, sheared mink, sable, chinchilla, fox, beaver, and exquisite leathers and shearlings in the latest styles from Europe. Plus, our consignment boutique is full of gorgeous furs priced at a fraction of the original cost. No other furrier in Metro Detroit can match our quality, our selection, or our prices.
Celebrating 100 years in business. Call today, 248-855-9200.
Sit down with attorney Sabrina Cronin and her law firm. They'll stand up for your rights. Backed by a full-service investigative division, Cronin Law delivers results, whatever your legal issues may be. Put your problems on the table and see how much more Cronin Law can do for you.
We're the Cronin Law Firm, bringing more to the table.
Thank you. Attention all Castech graduates. Please join the Castech Alumni Association at the Castech Centennial Celebration Weekend, January 22nd to 24th at the Motor City Casino and Hotel. For more information, visit ctaa100years.org. See you there.
Mike's Fresh Market, Detroit's largest independent supermarket with the best prices, quality, and service. Enjoy our vast selection of fresh fruits and vegetables. Wide aisles lead you to our own in-house bakery and deli. Beef, pork, chicken, seafood, and much more. You can rest assured you will feed your family the freshest food in town. Whatever you need, you can find it here at Mike's Fresh Market. Mike's Fresh Market, with two locations, Gratiot and 7 Mile and Livernois and 7 Mile. Better food, better prices. That's Mike's promise.
With 20 top surgeons performing over a dozen of the latest knee, hip, and joint procedures at the hospitals you know and trust, we only have one question. Where does it hurt? Orthopedics and sports medicine at the DMC. Call 888-DMC-2500. The DMC's sports medicine specialists, the official docs of our Detroit Red Wings. With offices throughout Southeast Michigan and more than 30 rehabilitation locations, we can make you feel better in all these places. Call 888-DMC-2500.
Welcome back to Detroit Wants to Know. We're coming to you from the 2016 Wayne County Show Cause hearings down here at 400 Monroe in beautiful, lovely Greektown. As some of you may know, our register, our treasurer, retired. He retired. Raymond Wytovich is gone. Let us help you. You won't hear that again. We won't ever hear that again. Well, we may hear it, we won't hear it like that. So I'm going to introduce you to the brand new treasurer, Richard Hathaway. Treasurer Hathaway?
Steve, nice meeting you, sir.
All right, you're the new treasurer. First of all, nobody knows anything about you. Your predecessor had been here forever, so everybody knew everything about him.
40 years.
40 years.
Long so who, time.
Who are you?
Can I start off by saying, let us help you? I might not be as strong as the past treasurer, but just to give you a little of my background, I'm a Detroit guy. I grew up 6 Mile Livernois. I attended Catholic Central High School. And there's a few Catholic Central High School people that are involved in politics today, like Mike Duggan, my second in command, Eric Sabree here at the treasurer's office.
It's not a Catholic Central mafia, is it?
No, it's not. It's
okay,
not a mafia.
Okay, I'm just making sure.
Just public servants.
All right.
I graduated from Catholic Central. I went to St. John's in Rochester, New York, came home. I was a teacher for 2 years at a Catholic school, St. Andrew's High School. I got a job in the prosecutor's office. I was a trial prosecutor for 4 years. Got elected to the Recorder's Court bench for 4 years, then got elected to the Wayne County Circuit Court bench. Stayed there for 20 years. I got talked off the bench by Kim Worthy. And for the last 10 years, I've been the chief assistant prosecutor. Working with Kim Worthy.
What was your docket at the circuit court?
It was a large docket. We'd have anywhere from 800 cases a year to 1,200 cases a year.
What type of cases?
Major felony cases, rape, robbery, murder, divorce, custody, medical malpractice, products liability, auto accidents. And the key to being a successful judge is you had to resolve those cases either by way of trial or plea or settlement. Because the next year, you're going to get another 1,200 cases.
So if you had a docket caseload of 800, and you saw every manner of the human condition, it prepared you for this.
This is unbelievable. This volume is unbelievable. You know what I think has helped me in my public servant life is we're always there to help people. And this group needs the most help of all. I heard you say earlier that a lot of these people need jobs. A lot of them do need jobs. A lot of these people are unemployed. A lot of these people have disabilities. And they're here to get on tax payment programs.
Tell us, what was the process like of you being appointed treasurer?
Well, it was a unique process. I actually read as much as I could about the treasurer's office before I got interviewed. Three people made the decision. Kim Worthy was on the panel. Kathy Garrett was on the panel. One of the probate judges, Judge Freddie Burton, was on the panel. And they ultimately made the decision. There was about eight people that applied. There were some good candidates. Mr. Kavanaugh, Phil Kavanaugh, and David Chemansky, who had been with the treasurer's office for 4 years, and I might add, did a great job while
Dave,
he was here.
Dave really did a great job setting this up.
He really did a great job. All those people applied, and I don't know what finally made the three people pick me out of that group. It's like jurors going into a jury room. You just don't know what the decision's going to be from a jury.
I understand from your team that you plan to keep the program started before going and then enhance them. In our next segment, we're going to talk to Eric Sabree, you know, who remains constant here. You know, he was there during the last administration. He's here now. People are very, very comfortable with Mr. Sabree. Are you keeping many of the holdovers, or did you do like some new bureaucrats do and just start cutting off heads?
I think a few of them left when the treasurer left. But so there's some openings.
But that wasn't your fault, though.
No.
That was because of the unpublicized Wayne County brain drain due to the pension crisis in Wayne County.
That's true.
And we'll talk about that again. That's not you. Right. So you didn't lop off heads.
No.
All right.
You know, I've talked to Eric. We've seen the group that's here right now. And as far as I'm concerned, the group that was with David Chemansky and the treasurer, they're very committed, they're hardworking people, and I want them to stay with me.
Okay. Richard Hathaway, thank you. Congratulations on being our new treasurer. Thank you for being on Detroit Wants to Know. And I'm glad that your circuit court experience prepared you for the misery, the sometimes misery of the human condition.
Thank you, Steve.
All right, thank
great
you.
Great being on your show.
All right.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, we'll be right back with our good friend, Eric Sabree. Still with the treasurer's office, still standing. We'll be right back.
Eric wants to know,
what does DTE Energy do to make Michigan a better place?
Rodney can tell you.
We do a lot, like youth education and employment programs.
We fund over 500 jobs for youth all across the state. Many are neighborhood improvement projects just like this.
It's incredible.
Wow, that is fantastic.
So this is like a paint by number, this whole thing, right? Communities are such great places, aren't they?
They sure are.
Love the siding. Measure once, cut twice, right? DTE Energy. Know your own power.
Those in the know that it's all happening at the Detroit Seafood Market in Paradise Valley, including happy hour weekdays from 4 until 7. Mondays, it's dinner for two, including a bottle of wine for just $69. And Tuesdays, it's half off bottles of wine with dinner for two. Wednesdays, the Detroit Seafood Market offers all-you-can-eat crab legs for just $30. And who can resist a complete lobster dinner for two on Thursdays for just $69? The Detroit Seafood Market and PV Lounge in Paradise Valley. See you there.
Simply buying a gun is not enough. You need professional service and professional instruction. You'll get both at Action Impact in Southfield and in East Point. Good people don't have to be weak people. Learn how to protect yourself and your family.
Step in and step up to the next level in firearms and firearm training. Action Impact. Southfield and East Point.
Detroit Wants to Know is sponsored by the AFPD, the voice of independent retailers.
Welcome back to Detroit Wants to Know. This week we have been coming to you from the Wayne County 2016 Show Cause hearings here at 400 Monroe in the lovely Greektown. My guest this segment is Eric Sabree. You've seen him before. Eric Sabree.
Hey, how you doing?
What's up, man? Are you still the Chief Deputy Treasurer?
Still the Chief Deputy Treasurer.
All right,
still
do it all.
Still working.
Do it all, this Eric Sabree. Eric, usually we're at a grocery store with you, but today we're here real life.
Yeah.
Okay. Tell us about the programs that you have in place to save people's houses.
Okay. We have three programs that really help. Mm-hmm. And we also have some other agencies here I'll talk about in a minute.
I noticed that. There are other tables here.
Yeah, the other agencies. I'll talk about them in a minute.
But go ahead.
There are three programs. One is the stipulated payment agreement. Mm-hmm. That's available for anyone, whether you live in a house or you're a landlord, a business owner. You put down right now 20% of your 2013 debt, your taxes that you owe, and you pay 10% a month. And the goal is to get to 60% by June. That's very simple. That's available to anyone.
Anyone?
Anyone. Anyone that owes back taxes, you come in, put 20% down, 2013 taxes that you owe, and pay 10% a month for a foreclosure.
So all of those of you that took that little loan from the government, you know, by not paying your taxes and paying the, you know, betting on the time to pay it and the interest, you can get into that stipulated payment agreement.
And interest is 18% a year, though.
So it's 18%. But look, if the banks won't give you cash and you got your cash by not paying your taxes, you get into a stipulated payment agreement. I'm just saying, you know who you are out there. Now, Eric, continue, please.
The other agreement is an interest reduction stipulated payment agreement. That's something legislation passed last year.
That's
which
new.
Allows, we can reduce interest to 6%,
mm-hmm.
but there's a couple of things. One, you're going to pay less money as a down payment. You're going to pay less monthly payment, but you have to pay your current taxes as well.
Mm.
You have to keep up your current taxes, so you're doing both at the same time.
Okay.
That's the second one. You have to be an owner-occupant. You have to have a deed in your name, and you have to also have a principal residence exemption from the city. So
mm-hmm.
those three things, those things you have to have. Now, the other one is the distressed owner-occupant extension.
Mm-hmm.
We call it DOE, D-O-O-E.
Mm-hmm.
This is an extension if you owe 2013 taxes, nothing prior. You can get an extension to pay your taxes until December of 2016.
Woo.
But the interest is still 18%.
Wow.
So you got our recommendation is if you are owner-occupant, you have a deed in your name, utility bill, you know, your driver's license, everything matches, then you can get into an extension, protect yourself from foreclosure, but you gotta make some payments, otherwise you're gonna get hit with the 18% interest.
Whew.
Now, we have some other agencies here. The water department is here.
Yeah, I noticed that.
Because some people are getting foreclosed because of water bills have been transferred to the taxes. So if
wow.
you have an issue with the water department, they can go and talk
so
to the water
some
department.
Some of these people down here have had their water bills transferred to their taxes, and that's why they're getting foreclosed.
After 2008, the city of Detroit joined the program,
mm-hmm.
the state allowed to put water bills onto the taxes.
Mm-hmm.
Last year, the city didn't transfer the water bills to
mm-hmm.
the taxes. I don't think they're gonna do it this year as well, but
mm-hmm.
we're foreclosing on 2013 taxes, so some of the 13s were transferred from the city.
Wow.
Water bills to the taxes.
Wow.
So their water department's here, Veterans Affairs is here. If you're a wartime veteran, or you're a spouse of a wartime veteran, you can get funds to pay your delinquent taxes. So yes.
So wait, if you're a wartime veteran.
Or a spouse. Yeah.
So that means people coming home from Vietnam or?
Vietnam, they list the wars that you're eligible for. World War II, Vietnam, Gulf War, I think Korean War.
Desert Storm, Desert Shield,
yes,
both of them?
Both of them, they can go to.
What about the Afghan conflict?
I don't remember if that's on there,
uh-huh.
but they said if you're a wartime veteran, so.
Okay.
I would talk to Veterans Affairs and make sure.
Wow, okay.
So that's good. Also,
say that again.
If you're a veteran, wartime veteran, or a spouse of a wartime veteran, you can get money from Veterans Affairs to pay your delinquent taxes if you're in trouble. You have to be an owner-occupant. You have to own the property and live in the property as well.
Okay.
But also, one other thing regarding veterans, if you're a 100% disabled veteran, the city has an exemption for you or for your current taxes. You have to apply at the city assessor's office.
Okay.
If you're 100% disabled.
Wow.
You can get 100% exemption.
You know, that stuff's not public. I mean, it was public, but it's not public.
And the other exemption the city has is for income. If your income is low, you can apply for what they call a poverty or hardship exemption.
Okay.
Same thing. Room 804 in Detroit,
mm-hmm.
the Coleman and Young Municipal Center,
mm-hmm.
you can ask for a hardship exemption application. And they can, what they'll do is evaluate your income and decide whether or not they'll give you a partial or full exemption from property taxes.
Okay.
This doesn't help you with your back taxes, but it will help you with your current taxes.
All right. We're going to come right back.
All right.
All right? Because I want to talk about Taxpayer Saturdays.
Okay.
All right?
Certainly.
All right. Ladies and gentlemen, we'll be right back with Eric Sabree.
At the Turkey Grill, turkey is what we do. So if you want the juiciest and easiest turkey for your holiday dinner, get your whole fried turkey now and relax on the big day. The Turkey Grill is open early every day with their $1.99 breakfast special, turkey sausages, hash browns, and toast. And they always have delicious turkey breast dinners, carved turkey breast sandwiches, turkey ribs, turkey wing bites, and juicy turkey burgers.
At the Turkey Grill, turkey is what we do.
The Turkey Grill on Woodward, four blocks north of West Grand Boulevard. Call 313-872-4624.
When you're having a heart attack, this is how it feels to your heart. And if it happens at night or on the weekend, there's only one hospital team standing by on site to save you. Cardio Team 1, only at the DMC.
How would you like for this to be you? This is your chance. WVIE 107.3 FM and WHPR 88.1 FM are looking for people with outgoing personalities who can attract sponsors. If you're into talk, R&B, oldies, jazz, gospel, or soca, have your own radio show. We have block time available. Call 313-868-6612. Radio we can see. Broadcasting live in the Virgin Islands and Detroit.
This is Arthur Bricker of Bricker Tunis Furs in West Bloomfield. We're back with the biggest fur clearance sale in our history. Save 40 to 70% off on women's and men's furs and shearlings. Choose from mink, sheared mink, sable, chinchilla, fox, beaver, and exquisite leathers and shearlings in the latest styles from Europe. Plus, our consignment boutique is full of gorgeous furs priced at a fraction of the original cost. No other furrier in Metro Detroit can match our quality, our selection, or our prices.
Celebrating 100 years in business, call today, 248-855-9200.
Welcome back to Detroit Wants to Know. We're coming to you from the 2016 Wayne County Treasurer's Show Cause hearings here at 400 Monroe. You see all the people down here trying to take care of their business. My guest is Eric Sabree. Eric Sabree, we left off taxpayer assistance Saturdays.
Yes. We did, for the last 4 years, we've worked with Wayne County Community College. Dr. Ivory, Curtis Ivory, the Chancellor of Wayne County Community College, has graciously opened up his campuses for us to bring taxpayers in so they can avoid foreclosure. And we start February 6th at the Northwest Campus, February 6th. The 13th, we're at the East Campus on Connor. And then we go downtown February 20th. And on 27th, we're at Downriver in Taylor.
Awesome.
So this is free parking, and you don't have to take off work. You can come in on Saturday.
Okay. Eric Sabree, thanks for coming by.
You're welcome.
You've heard it. You heard it from Treasurer Richard Hathaway. You heard it from Chief Deputy Treasurer Eric Sabree. You don't have to lose your house. They're doing everything they can. The same programs are there. They've been enhanced. These tables with the extra help there. You veterans, come on down. Come on down, get some help. Don't lose your property. We'll be right back.
Find your path to success at Wayne County Community College District. From high-tech facilities to experienced instructors, to a range of programs that give you the skills you need for in-demand jobs. Everything you need to jumpstart a new career or advance your education is at a campus near you. And we're here to support you every step of the way. So why wait? Register today.
Welcome back to Detroit Wants to Know. This week we've been coming to you from the 2016 Show Cause hearings at 400 Monroe in lovely Greektown. My friends, you know, Detroit has an abundance of cultural activities. Abundance. But many of us, we don't go. We figure that's a white thing to do. We don't go to the opera. We don't go to the Detroit Symphony Orchestra. Well, it's time to get cultured. We don't go to the DIA as much as we should. It's time to get cultured. I have Kane Thomason Reedus from the Detroit Symphony Orchestra. He's going to talk to you about an amazing series that's coming up. That's a good way to get you started being enculturated in Detroit. Mr. Reedus, Thomason Reedus.
You got it.
Good to see you again.
Good to see you.
Tell us about the classical roots.
Yeah, so Classical Roots Celebration, it promotes, highlights, supports African-American contributions to classical music. It's something we've been doing for 38 years here in Detroit. We have the concert coming up March 5th. It's going to be honoring Jesse Norman, who's one of the most famous singers in the world. Mm-hmm. She happens to have gotten a degree at University of Michigan. She has a lot of ties here, a lot of connections. She also has a brother who recently passed away, Dr. Silas Norman, mm-hmm. who was an incredible force here for philanthropy, for music, for health. He was a doctor here, and we're happy, we're privileged, we're honored to be honoring both of them in our Classical Roots Celebration.
Okay. Is it just one concert, or is it across a weekend?
Right.
What is it?
So we've got one big concert with the entire orchestra, but then we also have community engagement that we're doing leading up to it. We've got up to five school performances that we're doing, where our current African-American fellow, this is a position within the orchestra. Mm-hmm. It's a development position where you develop as a musician, you develop professionally. We have a young member, his name is Josh Jones. He'll be performing at schools across mm-hmm. Metro Detroit, including DPS and charter schools. Mm-hmm. We also are going to be doing a chamber recital at Wayne State University. We also just did a brass quintet performance at Hartford Memorial Baptist Church. That was the home church of Dr. Silas Norman. Mm-hmm. They were thrilled to have the DSO there honoring Dr. Norman. He passed away just in 2015, so it was a recent loss, and he meant a great deal to that congregation, so it was very meaningful to have music be a part of that recognition in their service.
How much are tickets to the Classical Roots, the big one?
Right. So the big concert on March 5th. There's an entire range of prices starting at $15 going up to gala tickets that include a dinner and cocktail reception. So there's a whole range of prices, but it is affordable. We have ways for lots of people to get there. We have community partnerships that also distribute some tickets.
$15. That's less than the price of a concert at Shane Park. $15, and you can get culture with the Classical Roots at the Detroit Symphony Orchestra. If you hadn't tried it, you'll love it. Trust me on this. Mr. Thomas and Rita, one more question.
Yeah.
Last year, the Symphony Orchestra also had John Williams come in and speak about his soundtracks. Are you gonna have anything else really cool like that this year?
We have plenty of cool things. We don't have John Williams coming in, but we do a lot of things. We just did a big project called Symphony in D, which was essentially a crowdsourced symphonic work. We have our Brahms Festival coming up in February, a whole month of things that you might expect from Brahms and that you might not expect from Brahms, including a beard contest and a ton of music that is some of the best music ever created. We end our season with an opera. We've got a lot of things that you might not expect from the DSO, including our pops programs, our jazz programs, our entire classical series, chamber music recitals across Detroit. So there's a lot of stuff happening.
Well, let's start them off with Classical Roots.
Yeah.
We've got a month before it actually goes down. Where can they get information on tickets and pricing?
Right. You can go to dso.org/classicalroots and you will find everything you need there.
All right. Mr. Thomason,
thank
Rita,
you.
Thanks for coming.
Appreciate it.
Ladies and gentlemen, there's no reason not to have class. $15 for the price of a ticket at Shane Park to see T.I. and all those guys, or Erykah Badu, you can go get some culture. See, I knew I was going to have the symphony on here today, so I even wore my paisley. This is my symphony-going blazer with my paisley puff. You can do this. Be culture. It's Detroit. It's your city. Own it. Own it and get cultured. Have a great week. If you got trouble paying your taxes, go to WayneCountyTreasurer.com and get it done. Don't lose your house. And if you can't, hear your cousins, all right? Hear your cousins. Come down, they'll help you. You got a new treasurer, he will help you out. And to Mayor Duggan and the powers that be, you gotta get some jobs. We have to cut down the size of this. We have to, or we're gonna be in a tinderbox. Have a great week, ladies and gentlemen. We'll see you.